Since our inception in 1987, the Jamaican Association has become an integral part of the Bermudan culture. Not only do we stand united for our people, but we strive to make a difference for all Bermudans. Through our various efforts and community events, our main goal is to uplift one another through a helping hand. In this documentary, you will learn about our history, the purpose of our organization, our roles in Bermuda, and our hopes for the future. Together we stand as one. We are the Jamaican Association of Bermuda.
The West Indian Association started, and the Jamaican Association came out of the West Indian Association. And the reason why the association started back then, it was a statement made by an immigration officer, or not the Minister of Immigration, that was derogatory towards West Indian women.
Something that was done wrongly to a local family. The husband being a Bermudian, the wife being a Jamaican. She came to Bermuda upon marrying her husband. She then bought kids from Jamaica from a previous relationship. And those kids were then asked to leave the island without their mom.
Somebody had put something in the paper about one Mrs. Fisher and her children, and they went to the school and took the children out of school because they said foreign children not supposed to go to school here at that time. So it was a big thing that went on.
When we found out that we were treated like not even second class citizens, we're talking like third class citizens, we had to form this Jamaican Association to assist the Jamaicans, and we have assisted many.
After the association formed, I was the first man that joined it after they formed it. Yeah. And I'm in there. I never leave the association. I've been through so much. At one time, I was the only man in the association.
The first president of the association was Miss Sonia Durant Berkeley. She was the driving force behind the Jamaican Association at the time.
I would say the people that have had the biggest impact on the Jamaican Association in the early days was myself and Mrs. Hazel Christopher. And of course, we had a newer generation coming in with, you know, who have made their mark and their contribution.
After that, Mrs. Shirley Kins took over the reign. Then from Mrs. Shirley Kins, I took over and served for several years. Then things were going fairly strongly, but we injected a very vibrant person. And she, I can tell you, is an excellent president, was an excellent president. And she is Judith Morgan Swan.
The first meeting was held at Mrs. Kane's. She had a nursery called Round the Clock Nursery. I think at the time it was located at where the Rosebank place is now. And it used to run day and night. So she's also Jamaican. And she used to allow us to have the meeting there. That was our very first meeting place.
And then after that, Mrs. Christopher's shop was, oh, definitely where we started the discussion at Mrs. Christopher's shop. And we would say, Mr. Evans would say, girl, you like gotta do something. We have to start. And from there, it was at my house. And sometimes it was downstairs in the basement. But we plan and we prod along and we pushed and I think at the BIU hall. So those were the early years.
And we worked in accordance with the people, and we would formulate ideas how we can help Jamaicans on this island. Because in the early days in Bermuda, when I came in the 70s, it was extremely difficult for Jamaicans to live in Bermuda.
The association tried to help some of the children, like paying their fee to Bermuda College. And if they have problem, immigration problem, we would go to immigration and speak on their behalf. Mr. Winston Lalo would be one of the main person who does that because he's a Jamaican counsel, and try to help them in whatever way we can.
If someone passes away, a Jamaican, and they can't, there is no funds for them to be buried, we would then try to take that on and do, see that the last rites are done as humane as possible.
We had Hurricane Ivan that had really damaged most of the islands, well, not most, but some of the islands, including Jamaica, Grenada, and Haiti. And the Jamaican Association worked feverishly to put on various events to raise funds to be able to support those islands. We also, when I just joined the association, used to have an annual picnic. I can recall when my first time there, we had about 500 or so. And later we got about 2,000 people and 2,500 people the following year.
And when we have the community dinner, the community at the Shelley Bay dinner, we cater to every Bermudian. You come down there and it's people like San Grain. They have the music, they have the dances, they have the children and the playing all different kind of games, tug of war. You have the rides, and it's a day and a time when Bermudians and not only Jamaicans come together, but the community come together.
The Jamaican Association brought in a play, No Dirty Money, and we brought in about 7 or 8 cast members who went to various schools and TV and radio and spoke to children about drugs and the harm of drugs. And so we did that play, and we did it in association with Pride Bermuda, and that was really a great event. It kind of, I would think, would open the eyes of local people on island to see who we are and what we're about. Sometimes in, you know, there's that cliche, one bad apple spoil the whole bunch, but it's not necessarily so.
Some of the projects we have done in Jamaica include the Kingston Public Hospital, where we have adopted the female ward. And we supply paint and other material to give the ward a facelift.
And we also repair a school in Kingston that the top blown off. You know, we also give money to repair that school. Yes. And when the flood, every time we have a flood in Jamaica, we always try to put things together, like send a container. You know, we work with the Bermuda government and the people of Bermuda, because we get a lot of support from the people in Bermuda. They always, whenever we out there, we go out there, they always support us.
I feel that life is one thing, it's a circle, and we should give wherever we are. We should share. We should share.
There are Jamaicans on island that has played major role in this economy. I have said, even to the politicians, I've said, listen, Jamaicans have been here. We have wiped your children buttocks by being nannies. We have taught your children, you know. We have head up your prison. We have head up the hospital. We are in the hospital. We're not only head up the hospital, but as nurse and doctors, we are here. You know, we're here in the IT and the accounting and administration. So I think Jamaica plays a very strong role in this economy. It's part of its backbone.
And I could reflect right back into the 1897, when the first Jamaican prince, the first principal of the Barclay Institute was a Jamaican, Mr. George Acosta. And he served as principal for the Barclay Institute for 30 years. Simultaneously, we have other people like Mr. Victor Scott, who served at the Central School then, which is now renamed the Victor Scott School. We have one Mr. Snate, and he is out of, in Somerset. Then we have an influx of several Jamaicans who come here and participated in all activities and served Jamaica and served Bermuda well.
Because before, you find that a lot of people think of us as jump up, jigger foot, whatever you call derogatory we were given. So with us making friends and they see that it's not all bad things or bad people come from, some people make it bad, but they are good people and they're people who love the community and want to share and care.
I can't name all of them, but you got a lot of hairdressers, you know, nail technicians, stuff like that, that work here. In the beauty area, there's quite a few Jamaicans shop here involved, you know.
We have impacted the food, the dance, and prior to that, in the years gone by, the education system.
At first, when I come here, Bermudians isn't used to Jamaican food, you know? So, you know, if they come, but one thing they always impact them, they will smell something from the house cooking nice, you know, are you frying some dumpling, cooking curry goat, or rice and peas on Sunday. And, you know, everybody, although they never used to it, but they will say, what smell like that, you know? So, you know, sometimes they pass and say, let me taste it. And you see from the taste it, the cow foot, the oxtail, the peas and rice. Oh, I tell you, they dive into it.
I live more or less every day of fish and ting. Jamaican grill. Yard the kitchen. I see Bermudians of all, I'm not talking about Jamaicans, because Jamaicans is automatically there. But I have seen Bermudians of all walks of life go to these places to procure their food. Oxtail, in the 70s, nobody wants it. Bermudians will say, yucky! Now the first dish they ask, do you have an oxtail, please?
Jamaica and Bermuda has built a great relationship. And we're just hoping that we will continue and to respect each other and to do what we have to do.
I would like to see we have more members because there's quite a few Jamaicans here, but a lot of them haven't become members. We would like more support from them to help us, because the more we have, the better we could do things and do other projects.
One of the main goals that I want to see is the barrier totally broken down with the Bermudians and Jamaicans or West Indians and Bermudians and a whole. That barrier torn down, get rid of, where we think of ourselves as a people working together to see Bermuda in a great space.
Our long-term goal is to get a place for ourselves where we can do more to help, you know, both Bermudian and, you know, people in Jamaica or other country people, wherever the charity, you know, the call come from.
From my vantage point and my perspective, I could say it's going to be great in the future. Reasonably, we have a very vibrant and well knowledgeable president by Mr. Charlie Simpson.
When we talk about our connectiveness and how we feel about each other, we say it's Irie, man, you know, Jamaican talk. This is Irie. And we're all sisters and daughters and brothers. So therefore, I say one love on this 50th anniversary to Jamaica. One love to the people of Bermuda, and we love you and we appreciate you.
One love. That's it.
One love. One creator, one people, one love.
One love.
One love.